The economic security of New Mexico and of the nation depends on the next generation of leaders, workers, entrepreneurs, and taxpayers. But one of every four kids in New Mexico lives in poverty. Nearly half live in single-parent families. And we know that it's harder for kids born into poverty to do well in school, to go on to college, and to push themselves into a higher tax bracket. A couple of generations ago, families could make do with one parent at home and one at work. A college degree helped, but even high school graduates could earn enough to support a family. Things are different now. The global economy has shifted many of those entry-level jobs to other parts of the world, meaning American workers need to be better skilled in order to compete. All of these factors play out in Albuquerque's South Valley. This is a historic community of 50,000 people based on the banks of the Rio Grande. It's an area of great beauty and enduring poverty. Although there have been efforts to improve economic development in the area, many families here still take home less than those in other areas, and good jobs near home are hard to come by. The population here is mostly Hispanic and young. About a third of its residents are kids. A college education provides hope for those young people, but many have trouble getting there and succeeding once they do. New Mexico's education chief, Hannah Scandera, says it's essential to meet the challenges presented by a global economy.
As we look at professions across the state and the nation today, the expectations around technology, math, science are ramping up, even when it comes to just coming right straight out of high school. Nearly 50% of our students are not on grade level when it comes to reading and proficiency. So are we preparing our kids for career and college readiness? We're stepping in the right direction, but we have a long way to go.
Teachers are the number one school-based factor in how well our kids are learning. But so far, we don't have a very good way of figuring out which teachers are doing the best jobs.
It's difficult to evaluate teacher performance. I think it's important to do so. And I think we need to, you know, some of it has to be done by other teachers. Some of it has to be done by the school administrator. Some of it has to be done in classroom observation. And some of it has to, again, go back to the question of, are the students in that teacher's class actually making progress?
Keeping kids in school is also tough. In New Mexico, one-third of ninth graders fail to graduate within 4 years. Senator Bingaman says keeping schools small is part of the solution to that problem.
One of the reasons we have such a big dropout problem in many of these schools is they're too large. And there are all kinds of reasons why school boards choose to build very large high schools, most of which have nothing to do with academic performance. But I'm persuaded that we need to find ways to incentivize school boards to move to smaller schools, smaller learning communities, and that will help us with the dropout problem. It does cost more, but it costs the society to have people dropping out of school, and I think that the payoff is there.
Even students who go on to college are struggling. Nearly half are required to take remedial classes before they can start college-level work. And the more remedial classes they have to take, the less likely they are to graduate from college.
You've got to have better integration between the high schools and the community colleges and the universities so that it's clear that the high schools are preparing students in a way that allows them to go into university without remediation.
Congress also needs to make changes to No Child Left Behind, Senator Bingaman says, because the law isn't working the way it should.
The purpose of No Child Left Behind was a good one, to raise standards, to have more accountability in our educational system. I think it is not workable the way it's now structured, and proof of that is that something like 80% of the schools nationwide are not going to achieve the adequate yearly progress.
Struggling schools can learn from more successful schools, too.
What I think is important the federal government should do is to try to provide additional resources to those schools if they will adopt strategies that have proven successful in other schools.
But New Mexico's schools weren't doing better when we had more money in the state's coffers, Scandera says.
In the last 10 years, actually, we did have enough money in education. We had, you know, we were doing very well as a state from an economic standpoint, et cetera. And our achievement did not hit the mark. We were consistently rated 49th, 50th, whether it was fourth grade reading or graduation rates. And so when we presume that money is the answer for effectiveness in our classrooms and success for our kids, that's, I think we're missing the mark. I'm not saying it's not important, but we know that money is not the change agent. Our teachers, our parents, and our school leaders are the change agents.